like you. Be strong to hold.
Hello friends, welcome to another edition of Safety Tips, your number one TV program that keep you safe and keep the environment safe, reducing the loss of lives of the citizens. Today we're going to be looking at the topic head injury. Head injury is an injury that could be a bleeding or probably as a result of an heavy fall that will lead to the destruction of the normal head functioning. The reason why we look at head injury and we take it more seriously is because head injury has a secondary effect ranging from the space of excessive bleeding that could lead to immediate death, fracture of the skull. It could also lead to a spill of blood on the brain surface that could aggravate into stroke in future. Or finally, it could also lead to epilepsy or mental disorder if not properly managed. Hence, you need to know that managing an head injury is a very severe and important thing that you need to take seriously. So some of the major causes of head injury is a fall from a height, a vehicular accident where your casualty might not be putting on seat belts. So for you to make safe from head injury, you could also always remember that seat belt is an important factor when you're driving on the road. For you to prevent head injury when you're walking in a height, you know you need to have your helmet and also put a suspension sheet in case you're falling to make sure that you don't hit your head on the ground. Also, you could prevent head injury from a situation of what we call a careless play. Most especially for those people who have a bathtub. You have a bathtub, make sure that it's usually clean. Make sure that you have a bath mat that could stick you always to prevent you from falling. And when you're building your house, you could also prevent head injury by putting the appropriate tiles in each section of the house. And when we do this, the society could be safe from head injury. However, when you have somebody, a victim that sustained a head injury like this, the first thing you need to do is the rule. Make sure you are safe by putting on your gloves. If the person falls from a height, please take the person away from that environment because something else could just fall on you and cause injury to you or the bystander. If the person is the head injury is as a result of a road traffic accident, please cordon the road or take the person away from the scene of the accident before you administer first aid. Your safety could not be compromised when you render first aid. Secondly, you need to raise this part of the head. When you raise this part of the head, you give the person more assurance of excess oxygen that the person will need. The next thing you do as a first aider, you need to get a pad. A pad, like we said, could be made from a triangular bandage. A triangular bandage is a cotton-like cloth that is made from a triangle like this. It's in a triangular form. However, if you don't have a triangular bandage like this, you could use any cloth to form a pad. What is called a pad is when you squeeze this cloth together and use it to form something stiff that could help you hold a bleeding spot. So you form a pad. The next, you make sure that you look at the bleeding spot. If it's on the forehead like this, it is good for you to insert your pad, bringing it from the down part and holding it together. The reason why you bring it from the down part is because when you have a laceration and the person is sitting like this, the down part of the injury falls down while the other one is suspended. So you have to put the two together for the healing to take effect quickly. The next thing you need to do is to get a bandage like this. It is called a roller bandage or called a gauze bandage. It's a bandage. Where you don't have a bandage, you could tear a piece of cloth to be able to form this kind of a bandage. And what you need to do is to wrap the pad. You hold the pad against the injury like this. When you are bandaging, try to make sure that your bandage rolls from the back like this. Make sure your bandage rolls from the back this way. Make sure that the casualty's eyes are very visible so that the casualty don't feel dizzy along the line. So you continue to roll like this. In the figure of eight, remember that you need to keep a place where you will have your tie. You come, make sure that the pad itself is completely covered. Make sure that the pad itself is completely covered. Make sure as well to keep the casualty's ear very open so that when you're talking to the casualty hear you. And keep reassuring your casualty by saying, "Oh, sorry, don't worry, this injury is gone. It's very minor. It's going to be well managed." You keep talking to the person. The more you talk to the person, the more the person gets assured that he or she is going to be safe and healthy again. So what you do is at the end of you roll your bandage, you please tie a knot at the end like this. You tie a knot at the end to make sure that the bandage is firm. And any excess of the bandage, to avoid tickling, you keep inside for a nice dressing. So when you have this, you discover that your casualty is set to go to the hospital. What have we achieved by doing this? One, we've stopped the loss of blood from the casualty. Two, we've been able to calm the casualty down. And three, we'll be set to take the casualty to the hospital, hence reducing the effect of infection, reducing the risk of life being lost as a result of reduced blood that could come from the head, injury, and then you take the person to the hospital. When you get to the hospital, you must have first of all promote recovery by putting the two tissues together. Before you get to the hospital, they are already joining. You have saved the life of the person because you did not allow excess blood to leave the person's body. And thirdly, you have prevented the injury from becoming worse. How would the injury become worse? If the person starts moving from here to the hospital without any bandaging like this, without any covering, the person gets infected and the person could just die from there. So please remember that head injury, whether minor or severe, you need to get to the hospital. Because when they get to the hospital, the things that the doctor might need to do. One, they need to do a brain scan to make sure that there's no blood spill around the brain that could cause a secondary injury. They're going to manage the injury as effectively and do what we call prevention from infection. When you do this, you've been able to save a life. Once again, remember, head injury is a severe medical condition that needed to be given a serious attention. For you to manage head injury, you need to calm your casualty down by making your casualty stay in a comfortable position like this. Two, you need to put on your gloves and make sure that you deal with every environmental danger that could come to you and any bystander. Three, you use a pad which is made from any cloth or a standard triangular bandage from your first aid kit. You use it to put on the surface of the bleeding spot to help you stop the bleeding. Thirdly, you need to wrap all the pad with a bandage firmly like this. And fourthly, you need to continue reassuring your casualty in all the process before transporting the casualty to the hospital. Remember, head injury is an issue, severe issue that could take life. And that life you could save could also be yours. I remain your guide, Paul Orukamaya, on Safety Tips.
To dream, believe in strength, now I'm the only one.